Hi, everybody. It is Saturday, June 18th. I am now in Las Vegas. We played the Greek Theater last night with Chris Isaac and his band. We had a great evening. It was a beautiful evening, temperature-wise and everything. It was really great. So we had a ball, and then around 12:30, we got on the buses and hit the highway and got here about 5:30 this morning, and we're going to be heading over in about an hour and a half for sound check, do the show tonight, and then after the show tonight around 12:30 again, drive to Santa Barbara to play the Santa Barbara Bowl tomorrow night. And I believe tomorrow might be Father's Day, so lots of dads around here of all sorts. It's just been great. It's been so great to be out with everybody. The band is so good, such good musicians and singers on this. And Lyle is such a treasure to work with. I really, really adore the cat. He's really a unique artist in this world. And I've always been really thrilled to be a part of anything that he does. We've done all kinds of things since our first recording in 1988 when I did his large band album. But I thought, you know, I'm in Vegas. What should I do for Vegas here? You know, all the decadence and all the crap that goes on. I said, well, how about Amy Grant? Let's do an album that I talked about this back like in the 700 videos. I think it was around 720 or 19, somewhere in that range. But it's an album called Legacy, and it's an album of hymns and faith from 2009. Lots of little bits of information on this. It was produced by Brown Bannister, who I did tons of contemporary Christian records with, and Vince Gill, and it was engineered by the great Steve Beischer. And the band on this is myself and Chad Cromwell on drums, Tim Akers on organ and accordion, Kenny Greenberg and Vince Gill on guitar, Vince on mandolin and background vocals, John Jarvis on piano, Peter Wozner on piano, Mac McAnally and Richard Bennett on acoustic guitars, and it was mastered by Doug Sachs and Robert Hadley. I'm going to do a couple of songs, but I was going to read just a little about Amy's got a really another one of those people with a really fascinating career, and well worth taking, you know, a minute of time and go to her Wikipedia page. I'm going to just read a touch of this to you here, so I'm averting my gaze. I'm still thinking about you even though I'm looking up at this here. But it says, Amy Grant is an American singer, songwriter, and musician. She began in contemporary Christian music before crossing over into pop music in the 1980s and the 90s. She has been referred to as the queen of Christian pop. As of 2009, she had sold more than 30 million albums worldwide. Won 6 Grammy Awards, 22 Gospel Music Association Dove Awards, and her album was the first Christian album to go platinum. She was honored with a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame in 2006 for her contributions to the entertainment industry. Grant made her debut as a teenager, gaining fame in Christian music during the 1980s with such hits as Father's Eyes, El Shaddai, and Angels. In the mid-1980s, she began broadening her audience and soon became one of the first CCM, contemporary Christian artists, to cross over into mainstream pop on the heels of her successful album Unguarded and Lead Me On. In 1986, she scored her first Billboard Hot 100 number one song with a duet with Peter Cetera from Chicago days, The Next Time I Fall. In 1991, she released the blockbuster album Heart in Motion, which became her best-selling album to date, topping the Billboard Christian album charts for 32 weeks, selling 5 million copies in the U.S. and producing her second number one pop single, Baby Baby. She is the author of several books, including a memoir, Mosaic, Pieces of My Life So Far, and a book based on the popular Christmas song, Breath of Heaven, Mary's Song, that she co-wrote. Then it goes on with all kinds of information. I could just sit here and read that, and it would take all the rest of my morning. She's been married to Vince Gill for many years, and their relationship musically is really, it's a beautiful relationship to be around. I've done a lot of things with them, as a duo did one of Vince's Christmas live concerts. It was filmed in Oklahoma a number of years ago, and Amy was on that with him, and Michael McDonald, all kinds of people were in that. But I'm going to go ahead and play a couple of pieces of music. I did this earlier, but these are a couple more songs from that. I just, you know, she's really a special artist, and I thought for Vegas she was a nice counterbalance to it. So here we go. This is called Fairest Lord Jesus. Wonderful lineup on that one. There's additions to the regular cast of characters for this album. They had Gordon Kennedy and Vince Gill on acoustic guitars. Andrea Zahn was playing fiddle on that, who's been out with James Taylor now for a number of years. She's a fabulous musician. Alison Krauss was singing the harmony parts with her on that. Eric Darkin on percussion and Pete Wasner on synth. Okay, this one is called Fields of Plenty, Be Still My Soul. It wasn't that one. Hold on just a second. Soft and Tenderly. I'm sorry. Here, let me grab this one. So I think if I was doing a project, I would love to hear Amy and Rita Coolidge singing a duet together. Their voices just meld so perfectly, that breath and everything was great. I'll do one last song for you here. This is called This Is My Father's World. And the addition on this one is the great Biff Watson, also on guitar on this. And Vince Gill is doing the solo on this. I'm going to double check, see if there's any more info to be had. No, nothing, so I'm just going to play music. Here we go. This is My Father's World. Start Saturday. I love working with all these folks. It's such a wealth of talent involved in this community. So I am I'm gonna get running here. I did a cameo this morning. I got that done, a Father's Day cameo. I love doing them. It's really fun. Just have people writing me going, give a shout out to my dad. Would you know, give him some love, you know. It's really fun. I really enjoy it. Excited about tonight. I'm excited about every night that we're playing. It doesn't get better than this, I'll tell you. And then of course, then there's the flip side of everything. I got very, very dear friends here, just outside of Vegas, that I would so love to see, but because of the COVID restrictions that are in place for us to keep this tour safe, I really can't see anybody, which is really frustrating. Like I've said, one of the highlights of being on tour is always being able to visit friends around the country and around the world. but the way tours are threatened at this point with COVID issues, we really have to be cognizant of that. The first and foremost is the safety of the tour. And, you know, so many people out there are acting as though it's all behind us, that, you know, COVID's over, we're all healed, we've been healed. We're not. There's a lot of people getting it still. It may not be the numbers that we once had, but it's still there. And the only good thing at this point is if you've had all of your shots and boosters, if you do get it, the odds are, it's not a never 100%, but the odds are well in your favor that it will be a very mild situation, kind of like a flu situation, which is certainly what I had when I tested positive, and I had a cough for about a day and a half, and it was over, done, and I tested negative after that. So if you do the right thing, you can come out of this pretty well, but I don't want to have anything jeopardizing the safety and continuation of this tour. And again, I thank so much all of the people that are working, which are still front lines. You know, I go to the market, and they're still behind plexiglass, and most of the cashiers are all still wearing masks and stuff because they're dealing with public. But I look at the public, and most of them aren't doing anything. And it's a little disheartening. But I thank the people that are doing all of that. They're postal workers and police and fire department and grocery stores, and especially the hospitals that are still having to deal with this crazy. So thank you all for your service. And then still the heartbreak of Ukraine, seeing this on the news, and just the brutality and horror of this entire thing that should have never happened in the first place. And it's almost, you know, irreversible at this point, that even if it stopped right now, so much of the country is in utter destruction and dismay, that telling people, well, you can go home now. To what? You know, a pile of rubble that was once your home and everything you possessed. It's nuts. And then I was just flipping by the channels, and there's the everybody just, you know, talking about everything that's being exposed in these hearings, and the absolute grifting corruption of this past administration. It's just unbelievable, the Kool-Aid that this Jonestown of an administration fed people to take them down, to steal their money and try to destroy the... I mean, it's unbelievable. It's just unbelievable. If you wrote a script of this and tried to pitch it, companies would... No, nobody would ever believe that. But here it is in real time, happening every day to us. And we really got to save this country, we really have to be diligent about this. So it was nice visiting Amy. I really adore Amy. She's another special artist out there, really great. And I'm gonna go get ready because we got to check out of the hotel so we can load everything back in the bus, go do the sound check, the gig, then take off afterwards for our drive to Santa Barbara. It'll be nice to be up in Santa Barbara. I love that area. And then we'll continue up north from that. And then just everywhere. We got a lot of shows on this tour, which is great, which is exciting to me. So take good care, and I'll try to be back tomorrow, and we'll find something else to do, maybe. I'll surprise you. Okay, bye-bye.